Creating 2D animations can be a lot of work. You have to draw a lot of drawings to get a fluent animation. But for some instances, there's a very good way where the computer can do a lot of the work for you. Just tell the computer to keep position one in mind. You go a few frames on the timeline, you give it a new position, and the computer can do the in-betweens, it can generate them. This is called keyframe interpolation or motion tweening, and you can use it to move the single drawing of a stiff object or element around, or to move a loop that was animated in place across the screen so it is actually moving. In this video, I show you the basics of keyframe animation in OpenToonz. Just to get this out of the way, this video is part of a larger 2D animation class. If you're just starting to learn 2D animation, you should probably start at the beginning. There's also a beginner's guide to OpenToonz. If you've never done anything in OpenToonz, you should probably start with that. To save a little bit of time, I already created a drawing up here on a vector level. And this is going to be the drawing that we'll be moving around across the screen. One big difference that you need to understand is the difference between the select tool and the animate tool. The select tool allows you on a vector level to select single brush strokes and move them around and change them. And then there is the animate tool up here that you can also get by pressing A on your keyboard. And at first glance, this seems very similar to the select tool because you can click and drag to move your drawing around. But with the animate tool, you're not moving the drawing around, you're moving the entire column down here and all the drawings and all the levels that are on it in the timeline. So even if you add drawings later, after you've shifted the column with the animate tool, or you import drawings that you've already done, they will all be shifted the same way by the animate tool. And as the name is implying, we can animate the different positions we create with the animate tool. Let's have a look at the options up here. One thing that you should probably do is move the center point. This is the point that your drawing will rotate around. If we just leave it down here in the middle of the screen and we select the rotation tool of the animate tool, you will see what that means. It's rotating around that center point. In most cases, you would like to put some thought in where your rotation point could be. For our smiley face, I'm just going to put it in the middle of the face. It's almost like it's getting a little nose here. And if you use the rotation tool, we can see that this rotation makes a lot more sense. Next up, we have to make sure that we have enough frames for the actual animation. Right now, this drawing is only on frame one, but of course we want to see it for longer, so we can just extend the exposure for a couple frames. And now it's time to set our first keyframe to tell the computer to keep this position in mind as the first position that we want to animate from. And there are a couple of ways to do this. You can either take the animate tool and with the position mode activated, just move it ever so slightly and boom, you will see the key symbol appearing down here that marks that there's a keyframe stored on this frame. Alternatively, you can click on this diamond shape here and it will set a keyframe, or you use the keyboard shortcut Z. Now the keyframes with the position data that we have set is independent from the actual drawings. We can go in and click on a stack of drawings and even move it around. And we could click on the keyframe and move it around separately. They're both independent from each other. Personally, I prefer setting keyframes with the keyboard shortcut Z or with the diamond shape, because this way you set a keyframe for every parameter. Whereas if you just move it around or rotate it, it will set a keyframe, but only for that single parameter. On the timeline, you see that you have set a keyframe, but you might have set a keyframe for the position data, but not for the rotation data. If you right-click on the keyframe and open the function editor, there we can see in orange what parameters have been set for a keyframe. The most interesting parameter for us is the Y parameter, because I want to move our drawing straight down, and this only modifies the Y parameter. So let's do this right now. Let's go to frame 13, grab our drawing with the Animate tool, and move it downwards. If we want it to only move along the Y axis and not go left and right, you can hold Shift and you will see it will be fixed to that axis. Let's drop it down here. Now you can see that we have set a new keyframe, and this keyframe only saved the position data X and Y. And only the first keyframe has a keyframe set for all the other parameters. You can copy and paste keyframes from the timeline by clicking on the key symbol, selecting the keyframe, hitting Ctrl C, and pasting them, in this case, on frame 25 on the timeline. Make sure that the exposure of your drawing now also ends at frame 25. You can see that in the function editor, we have the first keyframe, the value of the first keyframe is 0 in the Y position. Then we have the second keyframe with -140 in the Y position, and then it goes back up to -0 because this is the exact same keyframe that we copied over. You can now hit play, and because the first frame of our animation and the last frame are identical, this is a loop. We can click on the loop button and then we can see the ball bounce up and down. But somehow this looks a little bit odd. If we go to somewhere in the middle of the motion and we activate our onion skin, we can see that the distance between the lines between every frame is exactly the same. The drawings all have the same spacing. In one of the earlier videos of our 2D animation class, I've already talked about how this kind of spacing often is not very natural. Objects don't just start with the same speed and keep the same speed throughout the entire motion. Most motions have to speed up first to reach a constant speed, meaning that they start with a very tiny small spacing and that gets a little bit larger, 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 larger and larger. So we get something that is called an ease out. How do we get that with the keyframes? To really understand what we're doing, we should have a look at another kind of view to visualize our keyframes. You can find that up here. This opens the function curves. And this shows the position data that we have for the y-axis on a graph. We're starting at 0, it goes down to -140, and then it goes back up to 0. This kind of straight line is called a linear graph. Now let me show you why this graph looks the way that it does. Let's say up here we have our first position. Now from that first position, we're going forward one frame, and let's say it's going down 10 units of distance. And when we go on to the next frame, one thing we know or saw is that the spacing, this, is always the exact same. So we're going to go down another 10 units, and the next frame, another 10 units, and so on. And of course, this is giving us the straight diagonal line down, and on the way back, it's the same, but in the opposite direction. Now, how would a motion look that starts slower and gets faster on such a graph? So when we go from frame 1 to frame 2, we want to start with a very slow motion, meaning that there is very little difference in the distance between the first frame and the second frame. So there's only like a teeny tiny bit of a nudge down. So this gives us our first position. And from here, we're going to go to the next frame, but this time the nudge is a little bit bigger. On the next frame, our nudge is even bigger, say like this, and this continues with the spacing getting larger and larger and larger. And this gives us this curve shape that starts very mellow and then gets very steep towards the middle. How do we set this up in OpenToonz? There are a couple of ways to do this, and we should keep an eye on both the spacing here and the function editor as we change this. One way to do this is to select our keyframe parameter on the y-axis and change the interpolation from linear or constant to speed in, speed out. And now have a look what happens when I hit apply in the function curves. We now have this softer start to the curve, and we can even grab the handle and make it even softer. And as we do it, you can see that the spacings at the beginning are growing closer together. At the time of this recording, unfortunately, I haven't found a way to apply an interpolation type to many keyframes at once. You will notice that if you select multiple keyframes and you change the interpolation type and hit apply, it will not apply to all of them for some reason. I really hope that they're going to fix that in later versions of OpenToonz, but for now, you would have to click on every single keyframe and change the interpolation type to speed in, speed out. The other way to change the interpolation mode of our curve is to click on the curve. In this instance, we select the second half of the curve, right click, and switch it to speed in, speed out interpolation. Now you can see we have this kind of softer curve everywhere. If we now play this, it looks like this. The motion starts and stops very softly and gets faster in the middle. We can exaggerate this a bit to see it even more clearly. If we click on the keyframes, we see these tangent handles appearing and we can drag them out. This way, we make the motion at the beginning even softer and in the middle even faster. As you can see, the motion begins and ends very softly now, and there's a big sweep, a huge spacing in the middle of the motion. Not every animator likes manipulating the curves with these tangent handles, because if you were to accidentally change your interpolation mode again, maybe with a keyboard shortcut or you deleted some frames, and then you switch them back, you will see that it could lose some of the settings that you made to the tangent handles. So what a lot of people like to do is to create the ease with another keyframe instead of with the tangent handles. Go along the timeline to a very early frame right after your keyframe, set a keyframe with Z, and now you can move this keyframe out to a later frame on the timeline. By doing that, we dragged a position that was very close to the beginning to be a little later, and as you can see in the curve, this makes the curve smoother and flatter. Let me reset the other tangents to the way that they were before, and now we can create ease keyframes for the other positions in a similar way. For the ease into the down position, we can go to a frame very close to the down position, create a keyframe, and drag it out. Same on the other side. Set a keyframe, drag it out, set a keyframe, and drag it out. And in the curve editor, we can now see the extreme form that we had previously, but this time we created it just by setting keyframes. And if we play it, we can see that it behaves like the other one. Starts very softly, big motion in the middle, and ends very softly. Because the first keyframes we set were already keyframes of the interpolation type, speed in, speed out, it also set our new keyframes to be of the type speed in and speed out. But one thing we should also do is make this interpolation type the default, because otherwise OpenToonz might put in linear keyframes, you remember the ones that give you those straight lines, in places where you don't want them. To change the default settings, you go to File, Preferences, and in the Animation tab, you can change the default interpolation from linear or constant to speed in and speed out. The animation we've got so far looks more like a yo-yo than an actual ball bounce. And the reason is an actual ball falling to the ground doesn't slow down before it hits the ground. We have a video about animation physics if you want to learn more about that. But of course, if you let a ball go, it only gets faster and faster and faster. Why would it slow down before it hits the ground? But we can also get this with our keyframe interpolation with just a couple of clicks. So let's delete our ease keyframes here. And oh wow, this looks already a lot like what we need. Now, by default, if we just set the keyframe with speed in and speed out, it might look more or less like this. And this, of course, also causes the ball to slow down. If we don't want it to slow down before it hits the ground, we need to move that tangent handle up. So our animation is only getting steeper and steeper. Let's delete the ease keyframes that we had previously too, and just do that with the tangents for now, like this. Here, we get a little bit of an unwanted dent because it's somehow overshooting that position and then going back up. That is not what we want. We need to move those tangent handles independently. And to do that, we need to right click and select unlink handles. And now we can move both sides independently like this and give it this nice V shape. You can see that in the spacings. They all start very small, 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 get larger and larger and larger. And here they are at the largest. And if we hit play, this looks a lot more like a bouncing ball. At this point, this might still feel like a bit much and very intimidating to you, but don't worry, I can only encourage you to try it out yourself, draw something, set a couple keyframes, and play around with the curves to see what they do. And as always, we've only just barely scratched the surface. There's still so much to know and so much to learn, and I will keep teaching you here on this channel. So if you want, subscribe and come back for more OpenToonz tutorials. There are also premium tutorials and brand new. If you want to support me, there is a Patreon. If you join the basic tier, you will get access to some bonus content and yeah, help me to make more videos at a faster rate. There's also a group mentoring tier. If you join on Patreon in the group mentoring tier, you get access to a monthly group mentoring call where you can bring whatever you are currently working on, a drawing, a story idea, a demo reel, an animation, and I can annotate it, draw over it, and give you tips and tricks and advice on how to improve it. It's a monthly thing, so you can use it to push your projects, always come back and show your progress. And of course, if you have any questions, for example, about OpenToonz, you can ask them there. In any case, I hope this video was helpful to you and motivates you to start animating. I'm Ferdinand for Animator Island, and I hope to see you again on this channel. Keep on animating.